since all of this and our big changes, I decided to do delivery home kits. So bear with me, this is my first ever tutorial since we're all being pushed to be out of our comfort zones. I am too, because it's important for me to be able to get this to you so you feel better and feel better about doing it. So some people have asked for me to do a tutorial, and that's what I'm gonna do right now. So like I said, it's definitely gonna be raw, but you know what? It'll get the information out. Let's just get started. So when I deliver the kit, it's gonna come looking like this. The first thing you're gonna do is gonna open it. Obviously. Okay, inside you're gonna have a set of instructions that you're gonna wanna lay out and follow along with me. The kit comes with a container that's marked labeled B. That is your developer. You have a container A. You have a brush. You're gonna hang on to this brush in case I don't get to see you again in the next couple weeks, so that you have this brush for the next kit delivery if you need it. It also comes with gloves, color wipes for after, and barrier cream. Barrier cream's not necessary, but it's great to prevent skin staining on your hair. So we're gonna go through that. A couple other things that you're gonna need, I'm just gonna put this down. A couple other things that you're gonna need in addition is you're gonna wanna wear a t-shirt you don't care about, because you're gonna need to pull up over your head with the color on it. You're going to need a towel that you don't care about for, you know, as beginners, and even sometimes, not just beginners, but even, you know, more seasoned stylists sometimes make a mess. So it's good to have this here if it happens to get on the counter, on the floor, or extra color on your skin while you're working with it. If you don't want to use a towel, then you can use a paper towel. The other thing you're going to need is your own hairbrush. So then we get started. So after you put a t-shirt on that you don't care about, the next thing you're going to do is you're going to brush your hair. You want to get all tangles out so that it's easier to work through your hair when you're applying your color. It just makes the process go a lot easier. And I'm doing this in live time, which means I'm doing it exactly as you guys would do it at home. So once you have brushed your hair out and you've gotten the tangles out, and it's okay if it gets tangled while you're doing it, you can just put the brush down in the middle and rebrush if it gets tangled, and then keep going. Okay, so after we've done that, the next thing we're gonna do is we are going to, if it works for you, the barrier cream. So you're just gonna open up the package, marked barrier cream. I make sure it doesn't spill in the bag. Okay, so the barrier cream is a little bit right in through here. You're just gonna take a little bit, and we're gonna run it all along in front of the hairline, working really hard not to get it on the hairline. This is especially good for people who have darker colors. Also, you wanna lift up your hair. You can put it all back through here. It doesn't have to be perfect. Also, for who have a lot of hair on the sides, you can do even the top of your ears, right through here. You can put that aside. Your next thing we're gonna do is we are going to open up our kit. So this is the color. We're gonna open that up. Then once you get the bowl opened, you're going to open up container B. You're gonna take container B, and you're going to put it into container one. It's measured so that it's okay. Some of the developer is in here, but if you want to scoop just a little out, that will work. And you can put that aside as well. Now we're going to mix. You're going to hang on to the bowl, and you're going to mix it up like you're baking something. The goal is for it to look like all one color and have a satiny finish to it. See, it's starting to mix together and have a nice light tan creamy look to it. Once your color starts to look like this, you are going to mix it for 30 more seconds. Make sure it's really well blended. Once the color has been mixed up for the 30 extra seconds, that is when you're going to put your gloves on. Next, whatever, because we mixed it, excess color, you're going to scrape it right here on the bowl. See? Because we don't want it to have too much color on both sides. Okay? Once we start applying, this is what we're going to be doing. You're going to be picking up color on one side of the brush. This side of the brush is great for sectioning. So the first section we're going to make is as if you were giving yourself two pigtails. So we're going to take the brush right here, the end of it, and we're going to make a line right here. It does not have to be perfect, but you just kind of want to have it in your two different, the best you can to have it in half. And you're going to put this side on this side of your hair, if your hair is long. If it's not, then it should just fall into place. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do, now that you have it, you have a nice line right there, we're going to pick up the color. That's about what you should have on the brush. And you are now going to lay it very gently. Not a ton of pressure, because we want that color to be able to land right on. And then once you're out, you want to pick it up again. You want the brush to always look like this. I am left-handed, but if you were right-handed, you'd be doing it with this hand. You are just going to use that again. Now, you are just going to trace it and pick this up. Again, just keeping it separate. When you get to the back, I find personally when we're doing my own color, which I do often, well, not that often, but these days I've been doing my own color. I find that putting your head down helps you with your arms a little bit. So now we have color going from the top to the back, gently. The next section you're gonna make is at the, just held your hook tie, at the top of the head, and you're gonna trace it down to the top of your ear. Again, does not have to be perfect. We just wanna kinda get four sections in there so it's easier to maneuver after this. So now we're gonna do the same thing. We are tracing that. I find it's best to hold the hair down again if your hair is long, because it helps give you some control. Same thing, start at the top. Even if you want to put your head up and have it right here, put the brush up and down so you know that's where you are. You're going to come down, same thing. I find when you draw with the top, with this, the tip of the applicator brush, and you just trace it down, just section it out. Again, doesn't have to be perfect, but as long as you have, our goal is to get four quadrants. Same thing. I find for me, because this is against my good side, that I flip my wrist around, giving me a little more control with the brush. Now, if you have very white hair, the first step you would want to do beyond this, before this, would be to cover your whole hairline. So I'm gonna do that now. This is if you had very resistant hair. You would start with this section. I told you this was my first video, so it's definitely not gonna be perfect, but it's okay. We're all learning something new. So like I said, if you have resistant hair, this is what you would do first before you do your four sections. You just make sure you really get under behind the ear. You're going to come all the way around the back. You're going to lift your hair like you're doing it with a ponytail. thing. We're going to lift it up over the ear. And again, just lift it up. Okay. Now, in your front hairline, again, towel or paper towel. If you have really dark hair color, you might just want to clean this up right in through here. The more time it has to set in, the more it will stain your skin. Okay, now we are going to work the first front two sections. And all of this, you can follow along in the directions. It says step by step. So right now, we are now on step 12. So now we are going to work one of the front two sections. So this is how I do it. If it's easier for you to come this way, horizontally, that's okay. I personally find it's more thorough when we start working in the diagonal. So you're gonna take the tip of the applicator brush and you're going to section this hair out, right here. Same thing, you're gonna make sure that you have that color right there on the brush, and very gently just lay it, putting the brush once this way and once the other way. That way and this way. Take the next section. I believe I had said put it into, yep, just sections as it's all covered. Take the next one. You can tell where the division is from where the color is on the root right there when we made our four sections. And then once you cover all of this, you are going to take the brush tip and just move it back in that direction. Okay. And I'm just deciding to reinforce this line for when I work back to the back section. This section is complete. Now we're moving to the next section and we're going to follow and do the same thing. So we're going to take this section, same thing, and don't be afraid to move your arm around, whatever, move it around until whatever feels comfortable for applying. You notice I hold the hair up with my other hand, keeping it out of my way. This area, you want to make sure there's a lot of color concentrated, especially if you have a lot of, so I like to call them natural highlights, to ensure that they're covered. Sometimes they can be very stubborn and resistant, so it's good to really lay that color on. Same thing, we're just going to move this hair back down. And now we're ready for the back section. Same thing, we're just going to scoop that along the edge of the bowl. Now the back sections, I know we can't see, so we're going to do our best with it. So same thing, you're going to start at the top of the head and you're going to work one of the back sections right in through here. Whatever's comfortable for you to lay it out of the way. If you have someone at home to help you with this, then this is great because they can actually see how doing it. Plus, it's a great new fun project for being quarantined at home. If you have someone to help you, it's a nice way to connect with them while both of you are learning something. I'm sure there's a lot of husbands out there that didn't realize they had an inner hairstylist with them.
kind of feel around for where you have it. Kind of imagine that you're where you can see it. I find if I turn my head, I can see it better. And imagine that you're laying that color right back to the center of your head. So once you get to the bottom, I find it's best when I start to tilt my head down, it's easier for me to get that color. So if you notice, my head is pretty far down right now. If your hair gets tangly and all this and it's getting frustrating, you can just put the brush down and recomb the dry ends, and that will help you get through your hair more. And that section is completed. Same thing, just move that hair down. We're gonna move on to the next section. Now we're heading to our last section. Same thing, we're gonna start here. We're gonna start kind of on the diagonal here. I'm gonna go back, 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 back. So at this point, this is our last section. Same thing, see what's on the brush. Again, remember we're keeping that vision of working from the center of your hair back to the sides. As a lefty, this is my more awkward side, so we all have one of those. Okay, I'm gonna try and work the back. With professional color that we use, even if it layers onto the, or, you know, our biggest goal is to get our, you know, natural highlights or white hair and regrowth. If a little overlaps on the color, it's okay. This is high grade color and it will be seamless. Okay, again, I'm putting my head down, just kind of feeling around, using my senses. The thicker the hair, the more sections you'll have. The finer the hair, the less sections you'll need. Job is just to get it done. Okay, so that is now our four sections. We have color everywhere. So now that we have all the color on, we're gonna just take a look again, especially if it's darker color like I have on. I wanna make sure I can show you guys that, so what it starts to look like. You can use paper towel or towel. Just wipe it up a little bit, and then just to give you insurance on your coverage, I'm going to show you something that stylists call, it's called cross-checking. So you get your, you know, it's good to have the color ready, and what we do is we section and check the hair in the opposite direction we applied it. So right now, because we came down horizontal, we're going to just check it vertical. So all I'm going to do is just section this and take a look. And if you see any spots that you missed, and even me as a seasoned stylist, I can see that. We're just gonna go in and just take a peek and make sure that we see color laying evenly in between the hair that we did when we did it horizontally. Just again, kind of feel your way around the back. If the hair gets kind of tangly in this because it has color on it, just put the brush down. Brush starting from the bottom up. If it was gotten tangly, we always brush starting up. We try and come up from here, we get a nice little knot system at the bottom. So we always start at the bottom and we work our way up. And we continue to do this on the other side.
again. I find if I turn my head this way, I can get closer to the back of my head. It's a good workout for your neck muscles. Okay. So now there are, by now you've generally got it covered, and that's the important part. If you feel someone like myself who's a perfectionist and you want to just double check, if you have a hand mirror and you would like to, if you're doing this by yourself, you can absolutely turn it around and just take a quick peek to see that you definitely have the majority of that hair colored. Just kind of sectioning it out, making sure you see color everywhere. Even if it's not perfect and through here, if you can just tilt your head back, if you have this opportunity. If not, then just, I would recommend even going over it if you wanted to. This panel right here, you want to make sure that is covered so that this way it veils over the rest. Before you are done touching this, one more time. Again, especially people with resistant white hair, we are just going to go around that hairline one more time. Making sure we haven't disrupted anything in the front, which again, is where we see in the mirror, where it grows in the quickest. I also recommend if you're someone who uses a root touch-up or a powder, if you still see some of that on your hair from the day before or previous, almost before you want to start, take a light damp towel and just kind of gently wipe away that that retouch color that I'm sure everyone has been using until you're able to get this kit. And then from here, again, you're still gonna take the paper towel or towel and you're just gonna just make sure that it's not, so you can see I got a little in my ear. Just scoop that up. Now, sometimes when we do this, we wipe some of the color off. That's okay. Before you finish, once you've done that, just very gently, wherever you think you wiped color off the actual hair, just go back and rebond. I have mixed up everyone's formula with a little extra color so that if you needed it, because sometimes the first time you're doing it, you need a little extra color. So there should be plenty of color there to be able to do this. Once you've completed that, you can permanent hair color, unless it states differently or I reach out to you, goes from anywhere from 35 to 45 minutes. 45 minutes for resistant hair. It's okay if you got stuck, doing something at home or watching something on TV. It just stops working after 45 minutes. But I'd say shortly around that time you want to be able to wash your hair. Once you've completed everything, like I said, you just want to hold on to the brush. Everything else can be thrown away. Everything else. Like I said, making sure with your towel or anything else, if you got any color on the mirror or the sink, you want to try and wipe that up as soon as possible, but give it a once over. All of this can go right in the trash. So the brush, all you want to do is rinse it in water. It doesn't need soap or anything. You just want to, the Dylon brush, you can just make sure it's rinsed. You can keep your gloves on for that part. And just make sure it's really good and just all the color is out of it. You can leave it to dry on a towel or just set it aside. And then this way, if you ever need it again, it's ready to use and whatever other uses you could find with a brush like this. At this point, you did it. You applied your own root color. And now that you've done all of that, you can throw your gloves out. Now it has been about 40 minutes for me. So at this point, I truly highly recommend washing this out in the shower, taking a shower. Putting our head forward in a sink could result in permanent color in our eyes mixing with the water. You do not want to do that. So my best suggestion is if you can't tilt your head back or have a sink that you can do that, shower is your best place. That's why you want to have a nice loose t-shirt that you didn't care about. Be able to pull that over your head. Before you go to start taking a shower, a little tip is that color removes color. So what you can start to do is just kind of rub the color at your hairline, just kind of moving it around. And then that's when you can hop in the shower. You are going to want to do two really good shampoos. Focusing on the areas that are important is the sides, and you want to really scrub the top, an area that a lot of novice stylists forget, and sometimes even seasoned, this area in through here, you really want to make sure you scrub that back center and even underneath. And you're gonna rinse and you're gonna repeat that again. Then you can follow with your favorite conditioner. And when you have completed that and you come out, if you see any staining around here, the last thing that you have in here would be your color wipes. You should have about 3 to 5 in here. And then you can just, anywhere you see staining when you come out of the shower, is you can just go right along that hairline and wipe it away. And then from there, if you're just hanging at home, you can let it air dry. If you want to see how it looks in style, then you go ahead and style it. If anyone has any questions, you know how to reach out to me. Thank you for playing along with my very first tutorial. Like I said, everyone's out of their own comfort zone. I wish everyone well and stay safe until we get to see each other again. I miss you guys. Bye.